Hey everybody, this is Pete Wenzel for AnyBrick, and today I'm going to show you how to create a bricky ocean in Blender by using a particle system. How to create the 1x1 brick will not be part of this video. If you're interested in this topic, check out my linked video. There are multiple ways to create a bricky ocean in Blender, but in this tutorial we are using a particle system. Like in the real world, we need a bowl, a bucket filled with water and something to swim. The bucket is the emitter of the particles. The bowl ensures that our water is not just flowing away, and the boat is just a boat, because it's more fun to have something to interact with the ocean. First, fill the bucket with water. Second, put the water from the bucket into the bowl. Third, wait a bit until the water surface gets a little bit even again. And fourth, just drive your boat. And now, all these in Blender. We are using a plane as emitter. Shift S, Mesh, Plane. And change the size of the plane to be as big as our ocean should be. The ocean's bowl will be a cube. Shift S, Mesh, Cube. Resize it to match the plane size and lower the side borders. You can remove the upper face. I don't want to create my brick again. I would like to import it from another blend file where I have already done this job. By the way, a link to this blend file I'm going to create is in the video's description. Good to know is that importing something from another blend file is not called import, but append. So append a brick from another project, we are file, append, and search for your blend file. Go into it with double click and have a look at the internal folder structure of every blend file. Everything that distinguishes a file from the default one is stored here and therefore can be appended too. It is important to know that usually an object consists of a mesh and a material. A material may consist of a texture, which could include an image as well. It sounds complicated, but it isn't, because the tool is doing most of the work, and that's the reason I usually import one of those. We go into Object folder and select a 1x1 brick and click Append. Blender automatically checks what is part of this object and appends all necessary entities to create a second scene collection and rename both. First one is for the particle simulation and second one is for supporting stuff. For demonstration reasons, I just create a low poly boat out of a cube. After creating the first half, I change the origin to one side by selecting the face via Shift S, cursor to selected, and do object set origin, origin to 3D cursor. Now we can add a mirror modifier to our boat. And if it's looking strange, just check the axis. Select the bowl. This is now our collision object. Go to Physics tab and add a collision. Be sure to disable single-sided, because otherwise we have to take care of our object normals. Just do the same to our boat. Collision and disable single-sided. Now it is time to create particles. Select the emitter object and add a particle system at the Particle tab. We want our particles to be created at the beginning and then remaining the whole duration without dying. Therefore, we increase the number, because they are always too less. So be sure that we will adjust this at the end again. Frame start defines the beginning of the particle emission. This should be 1. Frame end defines the end of the particle emission. On one hand, we want to have a small emission duration, because we have to simulate all frames, but can't use them for the final scene. But on the other hand, we can't shrink the duration too much, or we will get a particle explosion. caused by self-collision. This value highly depends on your ocean size and might be adjusted later, increasing the lifetime to ensure no particle will vanish during our scene. Enable Render as Object. Change the scale to 1 and be sure the scale randomization is set to 0. Under Reference Object, select the 1x1 brick we have just appended. Enable Rotation and increase the randomization of it. Currently, the particles are too light and jump back and forth all the time. Under Physics, we can change the principal simulation type to fluid simulation. Nevertheless, a particle explosion occurs, because it seems as if they are ejected with too much force. This is because the particles are assumed to be much larger for the simulation than they are in the viewport. Under Advanced Settings, we can reduce the interaction radius of our particles. In general, these were the adjusting parameters. Now, we increase the size of the emitter, the number of particles, and reduce the emission endpoint until we like our result. When the particles have calmed down, we can animate the boat with simple position keyframes. If someone would really look closely, they would also notice that the individual bricks are not really touching each other at all, but are rather embedded in some kind of jelly. That's the reason we shouldn't look so closely. Now that I'm happy with the result of the animation, I would like to adjust the material of the ocean. So I open a new window and go to the shader editor. On the one hand, the bricks should have a basic color, and on the other hand, some variation in brightness. For the variation, I need a random value. Since we are dealing with particles, the corresponding node is called particle info under input. In order to see our materials in the viewport, we have to switch to rendered view mode, because several particle properties do not work in Eevee at the moment. I connect the random value of the particle info to a color ramp, so that the random value is converted into a gray tone. Because I want to overlay this random brightness variation on a base color, I need a mix RGB node in overlay mode. Depending on how much the base color should be adjusted, the factor must be chosen. I use quite small values. It is important to select the lower pin as input here. The first pin is for the base color, and this second pin is for the overlaid color. For the basic color, I need a simple RGB node, in which I can set the desired shade of blue. If you're happy with this result, then you have reached the end of this video. Goodbye and see you in the next video. For me, it would be great if the ocean had different colors. In order to achieve this, we have two possibilities. First, coloring the bricks depending on their position. Second, coloring the bricks depending on their velocity. I have already used the first method in my Blender landscape tutorial. If you would like to know exactly how it was done, just check it out, I will add a link to it. With a color ramp, I can define the desired colors. With this, I replace the RGB node. It is important to change the mode to constant, so that no colors are interpolated. I would like to have white for the spray, and then light blue, blue, and dark blue. So I need to add two more color steps. At the beginning, I want to distribute them evenly, as the particle velocity is a vector, but I need a scalar, a math node is used as a converter. I connect the velocity to both pins and set the calculation type to dot product. The result shall be the length of the velocity vector. Theoretically, I can connect this output directly to the color ramp and get acceptable results, more or less. However, as I would like to have a little bit more control over the result, I add two additional nodes. Converter, math, as multiply. With this, I can multiply the length of my vector by a value, if the values are too small or too large for me. Converter, color ramp. With this, I can fine-tune without having to move my colors. Now you have maximum control over the particle's material. Now to sum up, we can create particle-based oceans with bricks that interact with objects and can dynamically change their colors. And that would be the end of this video. So hit the subscribe button if you want to stay tuned. Now you have reached the end of this video. But this doesn't mean you have to talk to real people. You may be interested in my new video over there. Or you could watch this recommended video. And as a last opportunity, there are many more videos for you at my channel.